Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continue with the series of videos I'm uploading about the LangChain and its different use cases. I will talk about interactions with APIs and how LangChain solves this. I just prepared a notebook similarly to other videos when I spoke about other use cases on LangChain. And here how LangChain solves this. First of all is using functions. We will see this at the end. It's a very simple way to use the function in OpenAI functions. And with this just create a query which will be sent to a URL with the get method. This is the most simple one, for example. A query done to the LLM will build the specific URL. You just pass the base of the URL and the content that you want to search for, and the LLM will build the final URL to query the place, and it will get the outcome and it will return back to you the output. The other ways to create to interact with APIs is just passing the to an LLM, an OpenAI LLM, the documentation of the API. The documentation of the API used to be a JSON, something like this, or a YAML file, also similar to this. Here is also a JSON file, but essentially what you will do is pass this a pointer, a URL, or to this file, to the file where you had the definition of the URL. This is a standard. You can pass you through in the documentation which standard you have to follow, but to define an interface, but it's completely standardized. And then it's also versioned, so you can define which version of the either OpenAI interface or the target API you are gonna use. And then you pass this information to the LLM, and the LLM will build a query to that API, and it will make the request using the request that the LLM had built, and it will return you the appropriate answer. In this case, the information is, even when is large, it's a large document, and probably there is not many models that we can use to do this. No, I refer, for now the integration is only using OpenAI models, so this is because this information regarding how the API can be queried is usually a lot of information, and you need to pass this as a prompt, part of the prompt of the query that you send to the LLM, and the LLM is going to read all this information and build a query to interact with that, or to retrieve the information that you want using the information that the LLM understands from this format. So not many models will be able to do that, only models with a long context window. So probably that's the reason that only they had this integration done with OpenAI models. And then here the easiest way and the first of all the easiest way and the way that recommend more than recommend the LangChain say that is the easiest way to do this is interacting with OpenAI using the get OpenAI chain, and this method you just need to pass the URL, and after you had the chain created, it's directly you can interrogate the query sending just simply natural language. The problem I found with this is probably the version I'm using with me in my notebook is not working very well. But well, I will investigate a little bit later, and if I find what is the problem, in my mind probably is the version I'm using, or the version that is installing here with or the launching OpenAI. In this installation. In any case, as I will show you the other method that is also using the OpenAI API, and you will see that it's pretty similar, and it's just semantically is slightly different how we do it, no? But here we just send in the technical interface. In the method, in this method of AP chain, we send them the description in text of how the interface works. So it's essentially doing the same. So here we the LLM had to interpret the technical details that is explained in this format or this one. Yeah? And in the method that we will see now, AP chain is just sending the information. Let me show you what I'm talking about. For example, this API, which is also integrated, NewsDocs, is passing the description how you had to use the API. So basically it's the same, but well, the format how you pass the information to the LLM is slightly different. So NewsDocs is already integrated as part as well of the LangChain library. So you go to this path, I pass you as well this link. You see that there is the description of this API. We had 5 APIs that they are integrated directly there. And the LangChain is taking care of how this works, no? So here they are describing where is the endpoint, what is the location, the URI, where is going to make the query, and then on here the request parameters, no, how to use it. We will see this now, and then on we will see how it works. So not this APIs needs a key. You can request this. This is news API, the one we are going to try, and you just simply get the API. And you load it in the environmental variable. You will see in a second. The first thing we will use is this one, which is open. You can take a look as well. Meteo is here. Meteo docs. And the same is here, the description of how to use the API. The base URL. The API documentation is also adding here. The endpoint is version 1 forecast, and I set all these parameters. And then this is the information that we are going to pass as prompt or context to the LLM, and the LLM will analyze this and create a correct GET request to this API, and it will make as well the chain will make the query retrieve the information from the API. We will look at this in a second. So you need to load your OpenAI key on memory on the environmental variables. We import the libraries we need. Here, as you see, we are importing the Meteo docs definition from the path LangChain Change API. We instantiate the LLM, and then on we just pass to the AP chain the method from LLN and AP docs, the LLN, the definition of the this is just providing context, as you perfectly understand, and the verbose equal true just to understand what the model is doing and the domains where to look for. You can extract there. You can, if there is multiple URLs or specific URLs for an specific purpose, you can limit the domains here. No, just if you want just to do search in your local region, you can specify this there. No, and you just make a response. You create a, you run the chain. Sorry. And you ask here is, this is the Meteodocs one. This is an API which returns you the weather conditions. And again, you can ask, you can pass all these parameters. You can ask temperature, snowfall, weather code, etc. Visibility, etc. All these parameters you can ask them, and then here, well, weather likes right now in London, you key in degrees Celsius. You just ask, and then as you see here, it has created a URL, and then if you click on the URL, it's giving you, this is the LangChain is accessing to the through the API. The API return this, and with this return is building a response. The LLN is building a response back to you. So you here print it and pin. So here latitude, longitude. This is everything that the URL return, and there is, this is the time series, the index, and also here you have the values. So if you look at the response, you have here, we have 10.3 degrees Celsius, and it's obtained from this URL. Here you can print the documentation how to use it, and now we move to the news API. For news APIs, we need a key, and the way to interact with that is just, well, creating a header, authorization header. This way, you need this format, bare space, the API key, and you pass, in this case, you can see here the how we build again the chain from LLM and AP docs. We pass the context, and we, in this case, as you need authentication, you pass the header. Here we are just passing, we can take a look what we can ask to the API, and again you can ask categories, let's say business, for example, or politics. In any case, asking about possible auction. It's just about business. We are going to change here. And here is, I'm just asking now, latest top 5 business news in USA. USA, sorry, and then you can see here what the, you can click on the URL and you can see what the, this problem I didn't have before, so let me 1 second to solve it. Yeah, I found it. Due to we had requesting the key this way, you get a token as developer, and then on you cannot do the queries directly on the browser because these queries had your IP address, the IP address of your router. Then they block this they block the access to the API with this kind of keys using the browser. But when you are doing the query using the LAN chain, it's using your local host IP address, and this way it can work. So the key that you are going to create is just suitable to do tests for, like, a developer and or integrated in an application, not to interact with this using the browser. But again, here last fight news in business news in USA, and then you get that one. So they are telling us that they look at in Dow Jones. Information on the Dow Jones major indexes, the fight of the A-Talent, the Mega Millions jackpot, Visa, Mastercard, Fin Settlement, and fast food chains, still using antibiotics in the US. Well, it's, if you ask for some other details, it can also include, for example, in this API, the sources, and many other things. It's just read the documentation and play around with that. And then on this is the other way to interact with APIs is simply, well, for those that are familiar with Google Search, you can just make a query with using Postman or whatever, and you can just simply introduce in this base URL what you want to search. There is many parameters as well. You can take a look to the Google Search API. I can include you. I will include you a link to you understand how which parameters you can introduce in this URL, and then on how we build the web request with a function where we simply create a prompt. In the prompt, you introduce the query, and it will extract from Google. And in this case, you can use as well DataGo or Bing or other search engine. Here you set up two placeholders as one is the query and the other one is going to be the request result. You create the prompt using the prompt template class, and you create a LLM request chain with an LLM from OpenAI and the prompt. Then on you create a question. Here the three cars most sold in Europe and the respective sales value, and here you get create the input, which is a dictionary with your query and your URL. Again, the URL in this case is google/search. You will see now after executing how you simply is executing a query. Here you have the query that is executing the LAN chain. You can go through and you see here is this one, and it's here is collecting the information from here, and then with the information that the LAN chain collected from this page here, for example, is saying the Tesla Model Y was Europe best-selling car in 2023, becoming the first ever EV top in the chart, blah blah blah. And then on you see here the information that you got is exactly 251,604. Yeah, exactly. It's taking the information from here. Dacia Sendero and Volkswagen T-Roc. And this is exactly the information that we get here. We have only three. We have this case we may ask if Google is going to use the same example, you can get the 10 cars more sold in Europe. And you see, it's quite easy in this case to interact. You are just the only limitation we have is that the documentation of the API used to be very long, so we had some limitation there. Here we cannot split the models. We had to use all this information in a single go because it's what is going to give context to the LLM to make the to create the request, and also in some cases to return you back the information. And then on this a limitation in the kind of LLMs that we can use. By the in LangChain, there are only OpenAI models integrated for this purpose, for interacting with the APIs. There is no others, so this probably means something that we need a long context window. For now, LangChain, OpenAI models are the only ones who can accept these long prompts as an input. Well, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoy and you think and it's useful for you. And that's all. Thank you very much. If you like the video, give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.